Okay, I got my shoes on. Yep. Oh. Got my feast. And got my staff. Let's see what else. God's word. Oh, gotta paint my door. That's right. Let's do it. Hey, Meg. Oh, hey, Wig.
What you doing?
Oh, you know, I'm just painting my door red.
Oh.
Yep. Yeah, you know, well, I mean, it's supposed to be blood, but, you know, blood kind of makes me a little squeamish, so, I'm using red paint instead.
Okay.
Ooh, Chick-fil-A! Oh, don't touch that! That's my feast! It's sacred!
Oh, gosh, sorry.
Yeah.
What exactly is going on here? The staff, the paint, the Chick-fil-A?
Yeah, well, don't you know? It's Passover.
Passover?
Yeah, Passover! And guess what, Rick? The Lord is coming tonight, so we gotta be ready. In fact, if we don't follow all of God's instructions right here, we could be struck by a plague.
What?
It's true! It's right here, in God's word. But don't worry, Witch. I have plenty of red paint for your doorway, too. Oh, and I ordered 2 Chick-fil-A sandwiches. Extra spicy.
Wait a sec. Let me see now.
Oh, what's right there? In Exodus, you'll see.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Meg. I think you're a little confused.
Really? No, I've been following all the instructions.
Yeah, but these instructions aren't for you.
They're not? Who are they for?
The Israelites. You see, when Pharaoh refused to let Moses and the Israelites go, he sent one last plague. He told Pharaoh that around midnight, that very night, that the Lord would travel through the land of Egypt. Every firstborn son would be struck down and killed, even Pharaoh's own son.
Oh no.
Yes, but God had a plan to protect the Israelites from the plague. He gave Moses and the people specific instructions.
Oh.
For instance, he told them to sacrifice a perfect male lamb, take the blood from the lamb, and put it on the door frames. He also told them what kind of meal to eat, and to wear their shoes and have their staff in hand to be ready to go at a moment's notice.
Oh yeah, that's good. But yeah, you know what? Why do they have to do all that?
Well, why don't you read here in Exodus 12, 13 through 14?
Oh, okay. Okay. The blood shall be a sign for you on the houses where you are, and when I see the blood, I will pass over you. And no plague will befall you to destroy you when I strike the land of Egypt. This day shall be for you a memorial day, and you shall keep it as a feast to the Lord. So, it was the blood of the lamb on their door frames that allowed God to pass over them. Wait, is that why they call it Passover?
Yes!
I get it! Okay, I always wondered why people celebrate Passover, and now I know. Every year is when they're celebrating the time when God delivered the Israelites from the judgment over Egypt.
That is exactly it, Meg. And hey, did you know that the lambs slain during Passover are a picture of Jesus?
Really? How?
In the New Testament, Jesus is called the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Jesus died on the cross as the perfect sacrifice for our sin. And just as the blood of the doorpost protected the Israelites from God's judgment then, the blood of Jesus takes away God's judgment now.
Wow, so Jesus is our Passover lamb. Huh, wow, that's worth celebrating.
Yep, so I don't think you really need that staff anymore, Meg, that red paint.
Oh, yeah, I guess not. Guess you're right.
But we can totally eat your Chick-fil-A.
Yeah.
Oh, look at that. So cute little lamb.
Oh, wait. Hey! Enough rap!